Buenos días y bienvenidos a la Iglesia de San Bernardo de la Parroquia de Nuestra Señora de la Providencia. Hoy venimos a celebrar 100 años de una parroquia vibrante que continuamente ha vivido el amor y la presencia de Jesús para tantos. En la liturgia de hoy estamos agradecidos con aquellos que emigraron de Irlanda y que construyeron esta iglesia con sus corazones. Hoy celebramos la variedad de personas que han entrado en esta iglesia para experimentar el amor de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Los rostros han cambiado, pero nuestro amor por Jesús se ha mantenido igual. Hoy celebramos ese gran amor.
Good morning and welcome to St. Bernard's Church of Our Lady of Providence Parish. Today we come and celebrate 100 years of vibrant parish that has continually lived the love and presence of Jesus to so many. At this liturgy today, we are grateful to those who immigrated from Ireland and who built this church with their hearts. Today, we celebrate the variety of individuals who have entered into this church to experience the love of Lord Jesus Christ. The faces have changed, but our love for Jesus has stayed the same. Today we celebrate that great love. Let us stand as a community of believers in love for our Lord as we joyfully celebrate 100 years.
Thank you. En el nombre del Padre, del Dios y del Espíritu Santo. La gracia de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, el amor del Padre y la comunión del Espíritu Santo estén con todos ustedes. My brothers and sisters, it brings me great joy to welcome you all into St. Bernard's on this morning, which we celebrate the 100th year of its dedication. And so, my brothers and sisters, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate these worthy mysteries by acknowledging our sins.
Tú que has sido enviado para sanar los corazones afligidos, Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Tú que estás sentado a la derecha del Padre, intercedes por nosotros. Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad. Dios Todopoderoso, tenga misericordia de nosotros, perdone nuestros pecados y nos lleve a la vida eterna. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Lectura del Libro de los Reyes. En aquel tiempo, El profeta Elías se puso en camino hacia Serecta. Al llegar a la puerta de la ciudad, encontró allí una viuda que recogía leña. La llamó y le dijo: «Tráeme, por favor, un poco de agua para beber». Cuando ella se alejaba, el profeta le gritó: «Por favor, tráeme también un poco de pan». Ella le respondió: «Te juro por el Señor tu Dios, que no me queda ni un pedazo de pan, tan solo me queda un puñado de harina en la tinaja y un poco de aceite en la vasija. Ya ves que estaba recogiendo unos cuantos leños. Voy a preparar un pan para mí y para mi hijo. Nos lo comeremos y luego moriremos». Elías le dijo: «No temas, anda, prepáralo como has dicho, pero primero haz un panecillo para mí y tráemelo. Después lo hará para ti y para tu hijo. Porque así lo dice el Señor de Israel: la tinaja de harina no se vaciará, la vasija de aceite no se agotará, hasta el día en que el Señor envíe la lluvia sobre la tierra». Entonces se fue, hizo lo que el profeta le había dicho, y comieron él, ella y el niño. Y tal como había dicho el Señor por medio de Elías, a partir de ese momento, ni la tinaja de harina se vació, ni la vasija de aceite se agotó. Palabra de Dios.
From the letter to the Hebrews. Christ did not enter into a sanctuary made by hands, a copy of the true one, but heaven itself, that he may now appear before God on our behalf. Not that he might suffer, offer himself repeatedly, as the high priest enters each year into the sanctuary with the blood that is not his own. If that were so, he would have had to suffer repeatedly from the foundation of the world. But now, once for all, he has appeared at the end of the ages to take away sin by his sacrifice. Just as it is appointed that human being died once, and after this, the judgment, so also Christ offered once to take away the sins of many, will appear a second time, not to take away sin, but to bring salvation to those who eagerly await the word of the Lord.
El Señor esté con ustedes. Lectura del Santo Evangelio según San Marcos. En aquel tiempo, enseñaba Jesús a la multitud y le decía: cuidado con los escribas. Les encanta pasearse con amplios ropajes y recibir reverencias en las calles. Buscan los asientos de honor en las sinagogas y los primeros puestos en los banquetes. Se echan sobre los bienes de las viudas, haciendo ostentación de largos rezos. Estos recibirán un castigo muy riguroso. En una ocasión, Jesús estaba sentado frente a las alcancías del templo, mirando cómo la gente echaba allí sus monedas. Muchos ricos daban en abundancia. En esto, se acercó una viuda pobre y echó dos moneditas de muy poco valor. Llamando entonces a sus discípulos, Jesús les dijo: yo les aseguro que esa pobre viuda ha echado en la alcancía más que todos, porque los demás han echado de los que les sobraba, pero esta, en su pobreza, ha echado todo lo que tenía para vivir. Palabra del Señor.
Can I welcome you all into St. Bernard's in this 100th anniversary celebration? A special welcome to Father Bill Reiser, of course, who helps out so much in all aspects of the parish, and to Father Joe Rice, a parishioner of the parish, the last one to be ordained out of the parish there. We actually have Ricky coming down the pike maybe as well, a seminarian for the parish as well. So we welcome you both in your presence here. Acabamos de escuchar en el Evangelio hoy acerca de la mujer, la cual había dado todo lo que tenía para vivir. En la primera lectura nos habla de una viuda lista para morir, que tiene una sola comida, mas para vivir. Pero el profeta quiere comer. Él dice, tengo hambre, dame de comer. La mujer en su pobreza y en su confianza simplemente hace lo que el profeta la pide. Ella en su generosidad no tiene miedo de dar en ese momento. Pues yo las agradezco mucho a todos por la generosidad que viven cada día y por el amor a nuestra iglesia. Su generosidad es una continuación del amor que se ha vivido durante 100 años aquí en San Bernardo. Oremos para seguir cultivando un corazón amoroso por el bien y gloria de su nombre. In the first reading today, we hear about the woman, the widow, who literally is ready to die. She's a widow, has a son, has nothing left in this world. She has one meal left. One meal left is all she has. And then she knows the end is near. And then the prophet comes to her and says, I'm hungry, feed me. Talk about audacity, huh? The prophet, I'm hungry, feed me. He knows the situation that she is in. He knows she's good as dead. No, she has absolutely nothing left. And she says, I just have this one meal. Feed me. Feed me with that meal. And moved with great love and generosity, she feeds. And as a result, she receives a great abundance of God's blessing upon her, where she goes from a position of death into life. Because the generous heart in which she lived out at that moment. And within our own lives, it becomes very easy for us at times, I could speak for myself, it becomes easy for me not to want to give. Because it's easy for me to have the mentality, in giving, I'm going to suffer. There's not going to be enough for me. But we've got to come to see and know that we are called to be a people who continually have a generous heart. And in giving, we are not losing, but in giving, we are gaining. And for 100 years, so many faithful have entered into this church and have continually given in their own way with what they can. Back in 1917, when the parish of St. Bernard's was founded, the people rallied together, immigrants from Ireland, and gave the little that they have, all that they had, so that we might be able to sit here on this day and experience the great joy, the authentic love of our Savior Jesus that makes himself present in the sacraments, that makes himself present within the walls of this church. I think about the men and women at the long day's work over 100 years ago who would come, who would dig out, who would grain the level of this foundation so the walls can be built, tired, I am sure, and having nothing. But they gathered as a community of believers with the hope that they would not just be able to find sustainment in the life of Jesus Christ, but that we would be able to be sustained by his love as well on this day. And so we look backwards for a moment, and we thank God for the gift of the faith of our brothers and sisters who simply allow us to be here and enjoy the love of Jesus Christ through the sacraments and one another. And as we look forward, we also have an opportunity to ask ourselves, how is the Lord challenging each and every one of us to give? How does he challenge us to give our very being to him? We see in the gospel today the poor widow who comes and she gives everything she has. 2 small coins she gives. We see the rich people before her go up to the treasury and give as well. And they don't give all of their treasure, they just give a piece of their treasure. They put some money in. They don't give to the point of hurting. They give what they need to give. They walk away still with what they have. But again, the poor widow, she gives everything. She gives it all back to God without fear, without worry, knowing that it would be God who would sustain her. And that is the mentality we are called to have when it comes to giving back to our Lord. We cannot think we will be pained in our giving. And if we do have that mentality, well, then we don't have that authentic relationship with Christ that he invites us to enter into. Because, my brothers and sisters, as I say time and time again, Jesus is not concerned and consumed with simply having us follow the check-off system of living out the faith. He's not simply consumed by how many rosaries we're going to pray each day, masses we've attended. Jesus is more than we're concerned and consumed with whether or not we truly have entered into that relationship with him, where we are fulfilled, when we can turn to our Lord in all times of need, no matter what. And in turning towards the Lord, recognizing the great peace and joy, the comfort that he bestows upon us, he then wants to see how we share it with those around us, how we live it day by day. In the gospel, again, there's 2 options to read from this gospel: the longer form and the shorter form. I venture to guess a lot of us priests like the shorter form a lot better, because this is what the long form says. Beware of the scribes who like to go around in long robes and accept greetings in the marketplaces, seats of honor in synagogues, in places of honor at banquets. They devour the houses of widows and, as a pretext, recite lengthy prayers. They will receive a very severe condemnation. For any clergy that reads those words, it puts us on notice and it reminds us what we are truly called to be. And that is your servant. To incorporate the love of Jesus into our lives, continually be transformed by that love, so that we might be able to serve each and every one of you at all moments. And I am so grateful. I'm so grateful that I can stand before you as your pastor on this 100th anniversary. And my prayer is that you continually challenge me to live out the holy life that I am called to live as a priest. My prayer is that as your pastor, I could continually walk with you, and bring you into that deeper relationship with the Lord, where together we continually experience that love, where together we share in the blessings that we have received, and that together we can move beyond these church walls and truly live the presence of Jesus Christ through our hands, through our hearts, and through our lips. How beautiful it is. For 100 years, people have sat in those same broken pews that you sit in and have lived it and modeled it so beautifully well. And how beautiful it is that you now have that great task of continually sharing in that joy so that for many more years to come, people can experience it as well.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And having confessed our faith as one, we turn towards our Heavenly Father with our prayers and petitions.
For Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy, that they faithfully live out the call to minister the needs of the people entrusted to them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por todos los oficiales elegidos en estas elecciones, que sepan con sus responsabilidades, promocionando el bien común para todos y protegiendo la dignidad de todos los seres humanos, roguemos al Señor. For the sick, the lonely and the addicted, the imprisoned, that they may know the nearest of Christ's healing presence at all the moments, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Por todos los que estamos aquí celebrando en este lugar sagrado, que sepamos responder a Dios con generosidad y corazón en todo momento, roguemos al Señor. Increase of vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life, especially here in the Diocese of Worcester and from within our own parish assembled now. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
En acción de gracias por todos los parroquianos que fundaron esta parroquia, por su compromiso de dar lo mejor que tenían, roguemos al Señor. For those who have died, especially for all members of our parish, that they now find the joy in the eternal reward, we pray to the Lord. For the intention we hold in the sight of our heart, we pray to the Lord.
Good and gracious Father, we ask you to hear the prayers of those gathered before you. We ask all these things through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Señor, mira con bondad este sacrificio y concédenos alcanzar los frutos de la pasión de tu Hijo, que ahora celebramos sacramentalmente, el que vive y reina por los siglos de los siglos. El Señor esté con ustedes. Levantamos el corazón. Demos gracias al Señor nuestro Dios. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ in the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis ut celi et terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. But through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate the mysteries. Porque él mismo la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan y dando gracias de bendijo, lo partió y lo dio a sus discípulos diciendo, tomen y comen todos de él, porque esto es mi cuerpo, que será entregando por ustedes. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. In giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Mortem tuum annunciamus Domine, et tuam resurrectionem confitemur, Domine.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Bernard, with all the saints on whose constant intercession and your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And at the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we are to say, Padre nuestro, que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en el cielo, danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día, Padre nuestro, sus ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos hicieron. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz les doy, mi paz les doy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia. Y conforme a tu palabra, concédale la paz y la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. As we prepare for distribution of Holy Communion, Deacon Gilberto and Deacon Derek will be in the center aisle, and Father Bill and myself will be in the main aisle up front.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Of course, before the final blessing, a word of thanks to a few individuals. First, Father Bill, I thank you for the presence that you have been here in assisting from Fatima to here, and the presence that you continually give. Brother Joe Rice, of course, lad from the parish here. As your mother kept telling me all week, you know, Joe was 3 years old when he became a parishioner here. And I was like, that makes him a relic, you know. And so we thank you, Joe, for everything that you have done, and the King Alberto for all you do within the life of the parish, and Deacon Derek, whose family originally on his mother's side grew up in the neighborhood from the parish, and he'll be ordained a priest in June. And so we pray for Deacon Mobilio and our servers, Ricky over here, who's from the parish, studying to be a priest now in formation, a seminary in Wiley who tagged along today, and of course, our great servers who are always with us, Edgar, John, Paul, Emmanuel, and they don't just serve, they do everything around here. They're around doing the trash, everything they do you could think of, we have them doing, and a lot cannot be done without them. And of course, Sister Susie and Renee in the parish office there, I thank you so much for all you do. Renee will be in the gym afterwards selling. We'd have special ornaments that we created for Christmas, and so they're going for $20 a piece there, and so she'll be selling them. You could also call up the office. We don't have them in yet, but you know, you can put your name on a list and whatnot there, and it'll be online as soon as I put it online. I'll get yelled at this week for that. And of course, Sister Michelle and Sister Rena May, I thank you for the great gifts that you are to the parish and all you have continually done in living out the beautiful faith and giving of your gifts to so many. Christine and your staff over here, you know, your staff, your friends that make it possible, the food pantry, we thank you, and for the gift of your love there. Of course, Edith, Alejandra, Resta, beautiful readings as always for your help. Bob over here is, he has been serving in this parish since how old, Bob? 70 years he has been in this parish, altar server, lector. He was in the hospital a few weeks ago, and I said, Bob, you got to get out so you could read at Mass. And he says, I'll be there, you know. And so it is such an honor to have you with us and just to hear the reading coming through your voice, like it's the voice of God coming out there. I love that there. To our musicians, Roland and Rosie Vasquez from our Spanish community, thank you so much for offering the beautiful music today. And to, of course, Monica, for your wonderful job. And Anthony there, all the beautiful instruments and the voice that you have up there. Thank you so very much. And I got to especially thank these individuals here, Frank Capinello, Worcester County Seal and Coating. He's been redoing our lines as a gift to the parish to beautify them, to make sure no one steals anything there in terms of parking spots. And to Jimmy Smith, Larry Collins, Kevin Letourneau, Michael Carbono, my father, for the work that they have done the past 2 weeks in transforming to what we have today. I can't thank them enough for just the generosity that they have given. And it's because they see the good stuff here and they want to partake in that. And to my brother who's running around doing sound, doing the video stuff there, and my family, my mother, we have a big feast downstairs afterwards, they're very COVID friendly. She has been making all different types of sandwiches and stuff like that, and she's been working her tail off. So please go downstairs after and eat something, or she's gonna throw all the egg salad at my head, and I don't want that at all. And so again, I continually thank each and every one of you, and I just love seeing the faces that are all gathered here at this moment. Faces of old, faces of new. Because as I look at Nancy over here, we just buried her mother, Fran Chagru. Our oldest parishioner passed away, 97 years old, and we had a beautiful funeral mass here this past week. And so it's great to see family coming back home. And it's great to know that so many souls enter into this church and experience the beautiful love of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And so thank you so much for all you do. And I just can't wait to see how Christ is inviting us to move this parish in the future. A lot of the physical stuff is done. Now the most important work needs to begin, and that is making his message known each and every day so that others can experience it. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.